When I diagnose a patient with heart failure, the typical reaction, unfortunately, is hopelessness. I want patients to know that there is hope in heart failure, and that a patient that is treated correctly with heart failure has a significantly better life expectancy and quality of life than those that are not treated and undiagnosed. So there are two types of heart failure. To understand this complex disease, I'm just going to show a normal heart pumps like this. A heart that is stiff cannot fill with blood, and so therefore it pumps small amounts of blood, and a weak heart can fill but doesn't pump out much. So compared to a healthy heart, a weak heart or a stiff heart is basically what causes heart failure. After we recognize that the symptoms we're dealing with are heart failure, we target the culprit. At the same time, we treat with medications to relieve symptoms and medications to prolong life. The symptoms of heart failure are very important because they actually describe the whole syndrome. When you have blood backing up because the heart pump is not working, then water collects in the lungs, and you have shortness of breath, particularly with exertion, or you can have swelling in the abdomen or the legs. When the heart is not pumping blood forward, you have symptoms of fatigue, dizziness, lightheadedness, and this is also during exertion. The advice that I give to patients that are diagnosed with heart failure is to form an action plan with a cardiologist that is comfortable in treating heart failure. Because if you form an action plan and are on correct medications, then the life expectancy, based upon the Seattle heart failure model, can increase your average life expectancy from approximately 5 years to approximately 17 years. That's a really big difference.